When man first set his eyes on the horse, he must have thought, this is a wonderful animal, serene and headstrong like a good king, and as strong as at least five men. This animal should be useful to us, to push, to pull, to gallop, to toil. This animal could be useful not like the lion, or the bear, or the badger, who have no uses, they're just a sort of predator and a pest. And man, of course, did use the horse. He tamed it, he trained it, he taught it to push, to pull, to gallop, to canter, and he built harnesses and bits, and used saddlery, and skillfully developed bits and bobs for the horse made out of metal and leather and wood, and all manner of carts and harnesses were cunningly contrived to implement the power of the horse. And of course there was an age of the horse, which must have been gone on for thousands of years, from the Arab states through to Russia and Europe and everywhere. The term horsepower was used to describe the mechanical power unit. Like, this engine is one horsepower, wow. And then five horsepowers. And now you could have any number of horsepowers you wanted, you know. You just make them think bigger and bigger. 1,000 horsepower, the old Spitfire, didn't it? And all that knowledge of horsemanship that was gained over all those thousands of years, it was almost lost, and it had to be salvaged by a few enthusiasts. And now the horse is really just there for, as a sort of leisure activity, point to point, and fox hunting, and sort of general leisure activities. And this serene animal, he must know in his heart of hearts that he is naturally a free spirit, and he'd always be stronger than any man. And we always have to remember that. You've had the almost imponderable joy of watching the John Simpson channel, which means you are a really good person.